hear the whispers in my sleep. The voices telling me this should be mine. You claim you trust me. You think I don't see the doubt behind your eyes. I'm gonna build me an empire, and it's lonely at the top. But madness and greatness can both share a face, and nobody will ever convince me to stop. It's my destiny. I was born to play this game. So fear me or love me, it's all the same. Try to find a chain that I won't break. A price I wouldn't pay for what I want. So you can call me calculating. You can call me calculating. You can say I've lost my mind.
You can say I've lost my mind.
You can throw me to the wolves, I'll be alright. I'm gonna build me an empire, and it's lonely at the top. But madness and greatness can both share a face, and nobody will ever convince me to stop. It's my destiny. I was born to play this game. So fear me or love me, it's all the same. Just one word, I'll let the world burn. Just one word, I'll let the world burn.
Well, everyone, welcome to Rising Empire. We are starting off with a BYWE championship match. I am your general manager of BYWE, and joining me until he has his own match, the Diamond, Rex Silver, and I am very much excited to see who wins this one. This is a big world title match. This man won his way into the tournament by beating the Diamond, Rex Silver. He is a tag team champion, multi-time intercontinental champion, and he is one of two people to win the Charlie Moosey Memorial Battle Royal. And if you excuse me real quick, I'm gonna go check on the Barbarian before the match, make sure he's ready. But this is a 10-minute time limit match. Take it away, Ruxin.
Well, what the GM failed to notice is, yes, this is for the title, but we must remind you, whoever wins this tournament gets a match for the BYWE title. And if one of these men make it all the way with that title, they're gonna get to pick who faces them for the title. We'll potentially be seeing who the winner is gonna face at whoever wins the tournament faces if neither of these men win.
That is disgusting.
I really hope I don't have to face him in a tournament.
And now with the Barbarian,
he didn't win his way in. He was granted his way in by that man, the GM. Definitely check out him, alright? He is a United States champion. He is a Intercontinental champion, tag team champion, and of course, the BYWE champion.
I'm just here to watch this one personally.
Rocky, sure, you know what to do. This match is a first round King of Wrestling tournament match for the BYWE championship. In this corner, you have the challenger, the Twisted Jester, and in this corner, your champion, the Barbarian. Ready? Ready? Ring the bell.
I just want to go on public record to state that isn't it kind of interesting that one of the corporate assassins is the referee for this match? Surely in the GM's mind to keep order. You can see the Twisted Jester failing to suplex the Barbarian. Getting a little bit of more leverage and tossing the Barbarian through the air. He's going for the pin.
One, two.
A two count on the Bavarian to start, but he's getting back up. But the Twitchy Jets is keeping at him.
Come on, baby.
He is giving his all right now. Straight punches to the,
stay on him. You got
to the sides in the back there. But nothing is seeming to face the Twitchy Jets.
Come on,
leg! Small strategy trying to get at the leg.
Two, three, four.
Come on. Once again, trying to cut the Barbarian down the side.
Come on, one.
Big knees from the Barbarian. He's been very on the defensive this match, but let's see if we can turn this whole thing around. Trying to, once again, lift up the Barbarian, but Barbarian is not having it. I see our general manager is watching over the BYW Championship. He definitely has who he wants to win this tournament right here. What is the Barbarian going for? Well, I guess we are not going to find out as he is hit yet again in the knee by the Twitchy Jester, who is continuing to chomp him down. This not only will bring him more even playing field, but will possibly hinder him from hitting that devastating choke slam later in the match. And if his power game is taken away, things like even this, he's going to be having a hard time to do because his whole balance will be off. Once again, now he's targeting more of the other knee this time, though.
Three.
That was pretty quick to get to three there, Rocky. Hitting his head into the side of the Barbarian. Just swatting him away. That foot is on his neck, and now he... Listen, this whole thing is just a rope break. And he's just got to
what
one.
You were the one who asked for this.
Yeah, it's correct. The Twitchy Jester was the one who demanded the BYW title. Once again, backing up. He just drop kicked him. That is... a lot of weight just going through the air. He is a strong man, and that definitely looks like a strong drop kick.
Come on,
just tossing him. Trying to take
on,
out the knees once
one,
again.
Two, three,
come on,
four.
The counting definitely seems to be a little favored towards the Barbarian in this match, but. Luckily, the Twitchy Jester has been smart to keep himself from getting disqualified. Catching himself. Tossing the Barbarian behind him. Causing a little bit of separation. And he's getting psyched up. He is pissed off.
Get him out of the corner. One, two, three.
I don't know really what that move was. But it seemed not to phase the Barbarian much. Now the Twitchy Jester found himself in the corner, but luckily had the wherewithal to try to engulf the Barbarian to keep on at him.
Come on, get him out of the corner.
That's a bit of a different move we usually see from Ninja Blade, but definitely exciting.
He's under the ropes. Break it. Come on. One, two, three, four.
He's changed his method from going from legs to now targeting the arm. Definitely hindering him from hitting the choke slam later on in the match. This is a sound strategy from a very crazy man. Club and blow to the back. Ninja Blade is going up. Axe-handed. Once again, goading the Barbarian into getting to where he needs him to be. He may not be as big as the Barbarian is, but he definitely is one of our stronger wrestlers. And that is it. The Barbarian will move up. Well, I'm just as shocked as the GM is. I can't remember the last time anyone's ever kicked out of that. The Barbarian seems pissed off. He's stomping away at the Twisted Gesture. And see, those will targeting the legs earlier in the match come in handy. But that was not a smart decision going for the pin there. He should have kept at him. Mind you, pin usually doesn't count if somebody is holding the ropes. Gets a privilege of having the ref be one of your tag partners.
Come on, get him off the ropes.
He's going for a bit of a chokehold now. He's going to try to pass out in. This could be it.
One! Barbarian!
The Barbarian kicked out one. The more this match is going, seems the more pissed off the Barbarian is getting. And the stronger he's becoming. I have faced the Barbarian, and I have faced Twisted Gesture. And I just gotta say, if either of these men walk out with the BYW each other, it doesn't matter who,
we
are all in for some big trouble.
Come on!
He's once again grabbing for the knee, but the Barbarian had the wherewithal to get out of it. The GM's getting a bit of a closer look. He was holding on to that BYW title for dear life. He does not want to see the Barbarian lose. He does not want to see his vision of what BYW should be fade away. This is a bit of vintage Barbarian, but he moved out of the way. The GM is actually a little scared. He thinks possibly that the Barbarian could lose this, and Twisted Gesture got a little bit distracted with all GM. Going for a bit of his own choke slam, but luckily for the Barbarian, he had the wherewithal to try to get out of it, but this is just what he needed to keep up on the Barbarian. And now tossing him with a bit of a Samoan drop there. He is tired and couldn't lift him up the full way, and that definitely showed with that kick up.
You got this, Barbarian.
These two are putting on a clinic to try to walk away with not only the championship, but mind you, the winner of this match will also go on to round two.
1 minute left, gentlemen.
And possibly win the whole King of Wrestling tournament. The GM is whispering something now to the Barbarian. Both these men are tired as we are soon reaching the end of the 10-minute time
limit. 30 seconds left.
He is trying to pull him back in the ring. Before we end this match, could he get the win in the final moment? He couldn't hit it all there, but he got possibly just enough.
10, 9, 8, 7, 1, 2, 3.
This match
4
has been forfeited.
Time.
We
thus
have a forfeit?
No. By forfeit.
By forfeit. Your winner.
He did not want the forfeit.
Hey, let him go. Let him go.
He is choking out Rocky Jackson. This is. I don't think the GM, though, is the person to kind of break this up. And the Barbarian seemed to full on ditch this scene already. His face is turning as red as the Twisted Justice pants are.
Is a little clown mad.
that he can't win a title via forfeit?
The GM is correct, but I wouldn't try to mock him right now.
Oh no, you failed. You don't get it. I don't get, you do not get another title opportunity. You lost. You didn't win. Titus cannot switch hands via forfeit.
Moving on to the next round one matchup. Entering now, we got Red Ace. He is a multi-time tag team champion, a United States champion, and a hardcore champion. And right now, he is looking to beat Elite. Somebody who really has been calling out a lot of it. This is the boy's money where his mouth is, and try to move on to round two.
Hello everyone, got my headset back on. I just want to remind everyone that Titus cannot change and be a forfeit.
Or, you know, you can get mad. You can get mad at all you want.
But if that's the case, I would have been in front of the champion as by technically Cyclone forfeited at Titus. Just letting you know before you be a common warrior.
And I could have been potentially a two-time URWE champion. But sadly, the whole thing never even happened because the Barbarian was interjected into Max Henkel while he is champion to this day.
Listen, not everything's about you, okay? Now, Elise, won her way in on Shockwave last month in a battle, Royal Brawl. She's a member of Blood Ritual, the first woman in BYWE history, making her debut earlier this year at Battle Stations. Now, I don't know if you pointed this out. This match and this entire night is taking place in 90 degree heat. Over 90 degree heat, actually. Plus
the first
humidity.
Round to the King of Wrestling Tournament. Get you ready. Ring the bell.
So, not only were these people to compete in multiple matches tonight, they also had to compete in the heat.
I can just say, even doing commentary in this heat is brutal.
Yes, and you have a match actually next, so Rex Silver, please leave me alone.
Hey, come on, come on.
Well, I guess I'll just have to watch this one when it comes out, just like everyone else.
Yeah, please leave. Now, Ace, former corporate assassin, let's see if he can use that smartness he learned from there to take this tournament win. But he's facing against the Black Witch, a unpredictable wrestler in BYWE. Bless him, Lexi. Armbar. Red Ace has a long history in BYWE. Was part of the original tag team Solitaire.
He's
been a corporate assassin. But Elise has already made history in her first year of BYWE. First woman made her debut and has even fought for titles. She's desperately gonna try to be getting out of this one.
What?
Made her way to the ropes. Trying to take out Red Ace. This could be a big win for Blood Ritual, who also has another person in this tournament who, as I said, will be next. It will be the Dark Eagle versus Rex Silver. And we also had multiple Corporate Assassin members, but unfortunately, Barbarian did not move on. And the winner of this match, though, we do know this, will face Twisted Jester. Red Ace has had some problems with Twisted Jester, aka Ninja Blade, earlier this summer. And Elise has never faced Twisted Jester, nor has faced Ninja Blade. So she will be in for a tall tax elbow.
One, two.
Bailey kicking out. Now these two wrestlers are gonna try to end this quick. You have 3 matches to win this entire tournament. And you have to do this in the heat. So So you're going to want to do this very fast. Ooh, club and blow from the UK bruiser. Going for a sharpshooter of sorts. Biting. Ruff needs to make sure to call him out on this thing so he doesn't keep doing moves like that. Red Ace competed last year in the King of Wrestling tournament. Lost to eventual winner Blue Spade. Blue Spade was not in the tournament. Barbarian and almost ending. Barbarian also competed last year, same with Twisted Jester, who was then known as Ninja Blade as Munchin. That actually had a head injury that caused him to lose his mind, so to speak, and become the Twisted Jester in the first place. Elise is one of the few people in the tournament actually to not compete in last year's, as Rex Silver made it decently far last year. Dark Eagle, then known as Eagle, was eliminated round one. Spunton Nightfall was also in the tournament, though he would be forfeiting his spot last year after moving on round one. And just a reminder of the person who did that. Double Barry! See, I always knew he was a great person. Now, Elise is accepting a count-out victory. Red Ace is going to need to make his way into the ring if he wants to represent that UK heritage. And Ori being stomped on. No time to rest. Sliding dropkick to the ribs. She's very smart, taking out the stomach and chest area of Red Ace, as it's going to make it harder to breathe, especially in this heat and humidity.
Five minutes remaining,
they are halfway through. What's she going for? Red Ace is dazed, she's trying to get him up. Ooh! Huge! Smashing his face to her knee. Red Ace might be unconscious. The refs to check up on him. He's possibly trying to send a message trying to knock out Red Ace. As Red Ace's friend, former friend, Blue Spade, has a match against Whole Leader later tonight, only way to win via knockout. And remember also tonight we have a huge Intercontinental title match featuring five wrestlers, and we still have the rest of round one, round two, and the finals all in one night. And both of these people right here will be hoping to win, and Red Ace trying to roll out of the way. Unique moves by both people tonight, giving it to all to win this tournament. Red Ace going to second rope. Elbow. Picking up. And we've seen this before. United DDT. Will this be all?
One, two, three.
Red Ace moves on. It'll be him versus the Twisted Jester next round. Well, now we're moving on to the next match in the fourth round of the King of Wrestling tournament. This man right here won his entry, winning at BYWE Pride in a Lumberjack Chaos match. And now he's hoping to make a huge upset and be the first one to ever pin the Dark Eagle. He matches very well a underdog in this tournament despite being a former world champion, intercontinental champion, and tag champion here in BYWE. Now his opponent, the Dark Eagle. He won his entry when he made his return at Land of Glory, winning a Battle Royal Brawl. And if somehow Rex River can beat this man, I highly doubt Rex River will be okay in the next round. Remember, it's not just about what you do and beating in your first match. It's about what you do in an entire tournament, and it's all about lasting long. This man right here though, former United States champion. He doesn't have the resume as Rex River, but, ooh, shake hands with Bravo to Mumble Rogue. But he is a force to be reckoned with.
The following match is a King of Wrestling tournament match. There will be a 10-minute time limit. If a pinfall doesn't or a submission does not occur in that time, the manager will do something.
That's correct.
In this corner, weighing in at 122 pounds. Standing at 5 feet 5 inches tall.
That's not his height.
Rex, did you shave your legs?
I always do.
You vote and pay taxes. And in this corner, weighing in at 220 pounds, standing at 6 feet tall, hailing from the seventh circle of hell.
I don't think any of that's true.
Eagle. Ring the bell.
Now, despite that inaccurate information, as these two are about the same height, I can say this. I may not know his weight or anything like that, but I do know Dark Eagle was once from America, not the seventh circle of hell. Around this time last year, he was a patriotic American, but after his debut, he started to lose a little, including the first round of the King of Wrestling tournament. Last year, he was eliminated. He would go on to be injured and then give his soul to the Fallen. So I can confirm that he is not only not from the seventh circle of hell and 100% American, he's also 100% unstoppable. Many kicks, a springboard elbow, a diving bulldog has done nothing to stop this man right here. This could be one of his biggest wins of his whole career, because if he can win this entire tournament, first of all, he becomes King of Wrestling. And he will get a future world title match and will face the Barbarian. And we know those two have never had a match and in any sort of way with pinfall or submissions. Rex River is gonna need to mount a comeback, had high offense to begin the match, but getting thrown down real quick by the Dark Eagle's dominant offense. I'm really impressed though with the Dark Eagle wearing all black in this over 90 degrees heat. Though I'm sure he's used to heat, and I'm sure he's been to hell and things like that, so I don't know if this affects him. But Rex River being very smart, wearing some gear that will help him last longer in the heat, which could help him in the long term of this tournament. Because not only are you wrestling all these matches, you have to wrestle them all in over 90 degrees heat, plus humidity. And as soon as this round one ends, round two begins right after. So there is no more resting. You have to immediately start. Ooh, Stonewall Elbow did not work. There is no rest. Jumping at him. Ooh, Dark Eagle dropped to a knee. And not for long. Rex Silva doesn't know what to do. Nothing has taken him out. Mudhole being stomped in the chest of Rex Silva.
You gotta get out of the corner.
I think he got him on the throat a little bit. Taking him to the outside.
One.
What the Dark Eagle is going for.
Two.
Oh, jumping out the apron. Ooh. Landing into the wall.
One.
Two. Welcome ball drop kick.
Three.
Back to. Suicide dive! Oh my god, we've never seen that from Rex Silva in his career here at BYWE.
Three,
he's giving it his absolute all to win this tournament.
Six. Seven.
Counts at seven.
Eight.
Oh. He's being smart, getting into the ring. Count got very close to Rex Silva. Moving on, remember, that's all he needed. Ooh, submission hold applied. All he needed was to get him to be counted out. Tournament continues via pinfall or submission and countouts and disqualification. Rex Silva might be knocked out. Nope. That would have awesome. Helped the Dark Eagle move on in the tournament. Possibly trying to insult Rex Silva as his friend Blue Spade faces
the
leader of Blood Ritual later tonight in a CT Street fight with Blue Spade's career on the line. But let's focus on these two men facing off for the first time ever and putting on a show for everyone. Everyone has been giving it their all in the round one of this tournament. What is
Rex, do you submit?
Interesting submission audio
submit, Rex.
By Josh Eager. Rex Silva could have only verbally submitted. He had his hands tied, his feet tied, and even his head bent back. Barely getting out of it. The resiliency of Rex Silva on display tonight. And look how easy he was just to put in an ankle lock and make it hurt. He didn't need to put in any theatrics, drop kick. Just needed to grab at your ankle. More high kicks. Second rope. Ooh! Drop kick, and Eagle has been dropped. Oh my, nothing is going the way of Akira. Diving closing, Eagle staggered. Trying to brush it off. Going to the top rope. Ooh. Going for this again. Stone. Wall, elbow, staggered. No, no, no. Rex has given his all. Has only one move left in his arsenal, and it's a move that's won him many championships and many matches.
One.
Final notice.
Three.
Trying to use the full count. But if he can hit that final notice, he may just beat the Dark Eagle. He doesn't need to get him down forever. You only need to get your opponent down for a count of three. Ooh. Big chop. What's Dark Eagle going for? Ooh! See, that's what I was talking about earlier, with his strength. Ooh, big boot. Just simply grabbing you in ways that don't look, you know, the most efficient, but he's just that strong, one hand can toss you across the ring. Simply grabbing at any of your body parts hurts. This man is dominant. This man is a destroyer. Ooh. And this man might be moving on to the next round if he can just figure out a way to put out this resilient Rex Silver.
Rex, you gonna tap?
So I can say whoever wins
Rex, you tap?
Has put on a good first round showing. This entire first round have been filled with great matches. Ooh. There might not be much more left in Rex Silver's tank.
1 minute remaining left in the match.
1 minute is left in this match. Getting him up on his shoulders. Ooh. And that is it.
Your winner.
And I think Dark Eagle could have done that earlier on.
In the King of Wrestling tournament.
But he just wanted to destroy Rex Silver.
The phrase Battlerox Rex will
pay. Now we move on to the final fourth round match. And it is for the United States Championship. This man is a former hardcore champion and current tag team champion, won his way in at a point break, winning a Battle Royal Rumble, which also earned him this United States title match, which he was supposed to get Atlanta Glory, but of course I had other ideas, but it doesn't matter if it was Atlanta Glory or tonight, he will lose to Black Hearts. But this match has so much on the line due to the fact that if you win this match, you're United States champion. And if you win this entire tournament, you are king. And you get a future world title match. So you could be holding all the gold very soon. Especially speaking that Spencer Knifer also has the tag team championships as well. But this man right here is the current United States champion. He's a former tag team champion as well. And he's also held the United States title before. And this man will continue to hold the United States championship. Because if he wins this matchup, he is the longest United States champion in history. So a lot is at stake here tonight in this matchup.
The following match. The following match is scheduled for one fall, and it is both a King of Wrestling first round match and a United States title match. In this corner, weighing in at 143 pounds, standing at 5'6" tall, hailing from underneath the manager's butt.
Okay, that was height, weight,
and in this corner,
none of that's true.
One half of your tag team champions, weighing in at 113 pounds, standing
what?
At
5 feet, 4 inches tall, Spencer Nightfall.
Okay, those heights and weights are not accurate for Spencer Nightfall. I don't know him well, but I don't believe that's accurate. These two, starting off strong, good aggression. Spencer Nightfall might need, ooh, spinning kick. Let's say these two men will have a hard time. Ooh, dodging a kick, reserving their energy for the entire tournament. Spencer Nightfall especially, speaking at a very high pace, high aggressive offense style that I commonly compare to a pit bull-like offense. And with this heat, the amount of matches you must win, ooh, running drop kick, to win this entire tournament, he could very well use all of his energy in this first round matchup, if he wins, which I doubt. But Black of Arts also does a lot of running kicks, cartwheels, and things like that. So these two need to make sure they preserve their energy, but they don't look like they're doing that right now. They look like they're gonna give it their all to win this matchup. I don't even know if Spencer Nightfall is focused on round two. He's just focused on this United States title match. He wants to get at the Copa Assassins so badly. He needs to stay focused on the entire tournament, like Black of Hearts is. See, look at him. He's taking his time, catching his breath, hitting moves with precision, not just aggression. Because he knows an entire tournament awaits him. See, look at him, catching his breath, taking his spots. Oh, what is he going for? Climbing the ropes, not very common of him. Ooh! Sort of a, similar to his cartwheel kick, but onto the ropes. Going for a pinfall. Backing up on the ropes to make sure we can get it.
Two.
That's the Nightfall. Not letting him get any breath. Immediately running up and hitting a arm ball.
Black of Hearts, you submit?
Black of Hearts.
No.
Was very disappointed and took too much time and did not capitalize. And like I said, this man, Spencer Nightfall, has energy for days. But I don't know how much energy you have in this tournament if he uses it all right here in this matchup. Cartwheel using all of his weight onto Spencer Nightfall. And remember, after this matchup, round two immediately begins. Oh, roll up!
Rope break.
And we will immediately see Twisted Jester face off against Red Ace. And then after that, one of these men face off against the Dark Eagle. Ooh! Running chop block. Bouncing off the rope. Knee to the face. Ooh! High octane move by Spencer Nightfall.
One, two.
Kick out two.
Bailey kicking out. You can tell that energy. Ooh! Heartache. Did not go well with Spencer Nightfall. Bailey kicking out, using the octane moves in this over 90 degree heat and humidity was not good. He has no energy right now.
Damn it.
But if we know Spencer Nightfall, at a moment's notice, once the adrenaline kicks in, he will go all out. Cartwheel, ooh. We got caught with a drop kick upon landing. But we also know that at any moment, once Black of Heart uses his energy, he can go into rage mode. Oh. Vintage Spencer Nightfall! Catching him with an elbow! barely kicking out. These two
are
both hit the finisher.
There are 5 minutes left in this match.
Ooh, throwing his knees at him. Ooh, hitting a suplex. Very.
1, 2.
Oh, almost winning the match with that very unique Gauntlet suplex. See, that's the energy that I was talking about.
Feet's under the ropes, Spence.
Out of nowhere, these two have so much energy. And that moment of having to get his feet under the rope may have just cost him. Blackheart's up first. Heartache again.
1, 2, 3.
And not only does he retain the United States Championship, he moves on to round two.
United States Champion, not to mention advancing in the King of Wrestling Tournament.
And the now soon will be the longest United Champion in history. Well, round one has ended. We now move to round two of the tournament. This man right here beat Elise in the first round, and he will face the Twisted Jester, who, via forfeit, beat the Barbarian. Now this match is going to be hard-hitting, and it's going to be brutal. Red Ace won his way into the tournament by beating Constant, and the Jester beat Black Silver. And now, one of these men will make it to the finals. Though, it's a tall task for either man to win tonight. We could see either of these men very well win the entire tournament, though they will have to face either Black of Hearts or the Dark Eagle, which we will find out next. And after that, we will watch the Intercontinental Fatal 5-Way, and then we will see the finals. And after that, a CT Street Fight. Huge night of matches, so make sure you keep watching. Now, both men aren't going in 100%, but you can argue that this man had a harder time facing the monster, the Barbarian. Right, having the disadvantage, I'm sure Twisted Jester will make up for that. Oh, seems a bit angry. Will make up for that with a psychological advantage, making it rather equal between both people. But both men will want to end this match quick. There's still another match to the finals, and they could face the Dark Eagle. And either way, they will have to face him or the United States Champion. Only one more match after this. These two are gonna need to give it their all.
Okay then. The following match is scheduled for one fall, and it is a King of Wrestling Tournament match. This will be a 10-minute match. I will announce when it hits 5 minutes, 1 minute, 30 seconds. In this corner, standing at 5 foot 8 inches tall, weighing in at 153 pounds, the Twisted Jester. And in this corner, standing at 6 feet tall, weighing in at 230 pounds, Hailing from Liverpool.
I'm from Blackpool. Recently moved to Manchester.
We have to write it on the card. Red Ace.
I was about to correct him, but Red Ace is correct.
And ring the bell.
Now, Red Ace, though, commonly likes to represent the entire United States Kingdom, not one specific thing. Oh, grabbing at the finger, which could hold very long torment into the match if you aim for those ligaments. But he represents the entire United Kingdom, which is part of his motivation to want it to win this tournament. And of course, Switch the Justice's motivation is getting a world title opportunity, which he had in the first round, though that didn't go his way. So both people
Rope
motivated.
Rope it, get off him.
Brutalizing. There's a reason I call him the UK Bruiser. He is vicious. He is strong. But this man right here is vicious and possibly the most vicious wrestler we have in BYWE. These two have history together as they had a whole feud leading to Heat Wave 2 involving Black of Hearts, though neither man walked out with the United States Championship. These two are not going to do anything pretty. It's going to be all brutal moves. All aggressive moves.
Justin, you give?
It's just in pain. And now you can get a good view of that face paint, which is wearing off due to his brutal matches this tournament. These two are both not 100%. And it, despite having time to relax, they have to do this entire tournament in one night, and in the heat, Twitch Jester almost went for a quick win, but Red Ace getting out of it.
You submit.
No!
These submission holds could last long term for the entire tournament. Neither man are playing any games. Oh, I think he's going for Red Ace's snap, but instead turned it into an armbar. Though did play some mind games taunting him. Tried grabbing at the eyes and now being bitten. So it suggests it's all about mind games. I told you this match is not going to be pretty. Armbar of his own. Both men have a history of having dominant movesets in BYWE. Ooh, grabbing. Needs to be careful. Both men can't get the subs disqualified with all this grabbing of ears, eyes, and biting. Stepped straight onto the rib cage. Made sure his arm didn't get in the way, and now stepping on his shoulder. Like I said, he needs to make sure he doesn't get himself disqualified. But I don't even think Twisted Jester generally cares right now. He looks like he is just more focused on holding Red Ace. Now grabbing at his throat. Oh,
hey.
Now it's his turn grabbing at the ligaments,
one,
bending the
two,
fingers back.
Three, four.
This Red Ace is writhing in pain.
There are 5 minutes left in this match.
Only made it to the halfway point. Sliding drop kick. Red Ace's hand is very much needed for doing the underhook DDT. Or as I like to call it, the United DDT. Ooh, jumped off the apron but got caught by
one.
Red Ace.
Two.
Now this match can end via three. Counter, but at least one man needs to make it back into the swing, or it's up to me to decide what happens. Again, grabbing at the head. But they decided to get out of it, but not working.
And they're in.
Both men were smart to roll in the ring despite Red Ace's being in pain. Again, grabbing at the side of the head and possibly ear. It's hard to see with the max on. More brutal punches and biting. Clubbing blows to the back and now going for another submission hold. Just got out of it and threw his neck to the ropes. Red Ace though, smart to get away from that kick. Oh, but couldn't get away from the springboard elbow.
One, two.
Rope break.
Red Ace couldn't get his shoulders up, but did get his feet to the ropes. What is Justa gonna have to do? And what is Justa about to do? Going under the ring, this match is not no disqualification. Yet he has a chair. I don't know what he's going for.
Hey, get that out of here. Get that out of here. You gotta get that out of here.
Oh, it's attacking to a three.
Hey, you got it. Hey, he's disqualified. He's disqualified.
Red Ace is moving on to the next round via DQ.
Get off.
Twisted Justa does not care. Oh, oh my god. What is he going for? Oh! Oh my! Red Ace is definitely gonna be injured leading into the next match, and then now another chair. Red Ace went into this being one of the most dominant men in, and now he might just be the underdog in this tournament against stomping at the leg. What is he going for? Oh! Smashing his head between the chair. Again! Three times. Four. This is just disgusting. Oh! Red Ace moves on, but at what cost? Well, let's move on from those horrific actions from the Twisted Justa. We know Red Ace makes it to the finals, though he is severely hurt leading into it. And one of these men will be his opponent. He beat Quecksilver round one, won his way into the tournament via Battle Royal Brawl, and now only one man stands in his way. Lack of Hearts. In a way, reuniting a feud from earlier this year, a long-standing feud between the Corporate Assassins and Blood Ritual. He has a huge tax ahead of him, and I don't care if he's never been pinned. Lack of Hearts, he's gonna beat this man real quick. Now, you can say what you want about how Blackheart made his way into the tournament. Now, I gave him a spot, but he cleanly beat Spencer Nightfall to successfully defend the United States title round one. And now, in this non-title round two matchup, he will be the first person to pin the Dark Eagle. And remember, he doesn't need to pin him. Count out disqualifications, forfeiting. There's many ways this man can move on to the finals and be king.
This is a round two match of our King of Wrestling tournament. Introducing first, the Dark Eagle, and his opponent, Black of Hearts. 10-minute timer starts now.
Now, 10 minutes. This match must end. Oh, well, I guess Red Ace could actually be king just via that. Though it's up to my decision, and it could be a triple threat. Who knows?
But
I believe in Black Bolt's ability to beat this man right here. Come on, Black Bolt. Dark Eagle has been dominant all year. Well, even before that, ever since joining the Fallen, he's been on a dominant role. But you cannot deny the role Black of Hearts has been on since winning the United States title at BYWE Mania 2. And well, this man at BYWE Mania 2, under what I believe is bad circumstances, beat me.
Are you going to compete? Can you get up? Can you continue to fight?
Oh, Black of Hearts. Ooh, kick up. Eagle again trying to show some sort of message. His master is in. Oh, come on, Black Heart. His master. Sorry, I'm getting distracted. Listen, this man is a rude monster, and I'm just a bit nervous that Black Heart could get hurt.
Hey, that's a rope break. That's a rope break.
But, you know, I have faith in him. His master is in a match where Blue Space Crew is on the line. Former tag team partner and friend of Black of Hearts. Knee to side of head. The only way to win that match is via knockout. And we've seen him taunt Rex Silver, trying to knock him out, and he's seemingly trying to do the same with Black of Hearts. Big boot to the back of the head. Remember, this is the second match both of these men had to be in. These two are exhausted. They have to compete in 90 degree heat and humidity. Come on, Black of Hearts.
Do you submit? Black of Hearts, do you give up?
No.
No, he does not give up.
I'm not.
Come on, Black of Hearts. See? Oh, he's trying to pick him up, and damn it. Charging kick, straight to the chest. Nothing is working. Rex Silver barely got Dark Eagle down.
You're good.
Black of Hearts has unsuccessfully gotten him down so far. Come on, Black of Hearts. Beat this moronic Dark Eagle. Get out of this, come on. Come on, Black of Hearts. The winner of this match. Ooh! Big boot. Faces the Dark. Faces Red Ace. It will be the Dark Eagle, Black of Hearts. Winner becomes king of the next matchup. But this match has to have a winner.
Three.
Ooh, stomp to the back of the head. Black of Hearts can make this upset. He could become king and United States champion. And well, he will have to face the Barbarian. And either way, a corporate assassin will be world champion. Come on. Oh, going for a suplex! Oh, my! Come on, Black of Hearts!
One, two!
Barely kicking out in time. Come on. Another grueling submission hold by the Dark Eagle. Come on, Black of Hearts!
Don't!
Come on. Find your way out of this. Prove to all these moronic fans that you deserve to be in this tournament.
5 minutes left.
Halfway through the time. Headbutt. Oh, I've felt that one before. Come on.
One, two.
I'll be right back, everyone. I'll be right back.
Excuse me, Mr. Dark Eagle. Listen, I just want to come out here and talk to you real quick. Because that is your United States champion, which you are not anymore. I hope you. First of all, I just want to remind you of that one, that the Cobra Assassins took it from you in the first place, and. Do you not see this? Ring the bell! Ring the bell!
Ring the bell, I guess. That's the end of the match.
Good job, Black of Hearts! What? I cannot control you tapping out.
Well, everyone, we move on to the Intercontinental title match. Five competitors, one title, and after this, we have the final winners of the King of Wrestling tournament and the huge CT Street Fighter making his way to the ring. Recently returning to BYDE. Whoa. He may possibly win his fourth title in BYWE. But there's a strong field ahead of him, filled with multi-time champions. This man playing more mind games with Rogue, taking his time to enter. Now this man's a multi-time champion in his own right and current tag team champion. So one of the titles he has yet to win. It's the Intercontinental Champion. That could all change tonight. Definitely gonna win this. A former Intercontinental Champion is gonna take it back and bring it for the Corporate Assassins. This man right here is also a former Intercontinental Champion. Had to vacate it and now wants it back, but he will fail. Now all four challenges have entered the ring. Only thing left is this man right here. He won it last month and has been defending it diligently throughout this month, but his title reign could come to an end tonight. He's of course none other than a Canaan man side. But the Intercontinental Champion, Bobby J. Now this is one of the biggest challenges, I would say, of possibly any Intercontinental Champion. From my memory, off the top of my head, I don't remember a bigger Intercontinental title match than this.
All right, this is a Intercontinental Fatal 5-Way. Introducing first the challenger, one half of your tag team champions, Leonidas, and his opponent,
the Rocky Mountain Man, Rocky Jackson. Introducing his other opponent, Rogue. Here's a warning for you. Your next opponent is Cyclone. And your current Intercontinental Champion, the Street Fighter, Bobby J. Ring the bell.
All these wrestlers on the prime of their career going all out. Ooh, looking down with a double clothesline. Oh, second by Coachella. All the competitors are thrown out. Rocky's the only one left standing. And he's had problems with this man for a while now. Buzz has seen a lot of animosity between Lee Nice and Rogue ever late. Ooh, kick straight to the head. This man can capitalize right now if he can pick up a quick win against Bobby J. Come on, Rocky. You have time to capitalize. Oh, wait, he doesn't see from behind. Rogue. The dark horse of this match. As I said, he returned recently. He only did one or two matches before this.
Let's go!
And oh, right up behind him. Springboard chop by Leonidas. But before that, he didn't do much before he was injured. Took advice from the Fallen and now has joined Blood Ritual. Now this man, who's now on the offensive, Bobby J, made his debut earlier this year and has already won the Intercontinental Championship. But he's also stupid and left a Cobra Assassin, so I'd say his career is still at a loss right now. What's Leonidas going for? Sizing up his opponent. Decided to go for Bobby J. Diving elbow.
One, two.
Rocky being smart, picking his time to get into the ring. Now, that's one advantage of this match, is that everyone could be fighting in and outside of the ring. There is no count out in this match, so the title can only switch hands via pinfall and submission. And that is really nice. Going for huge dive, taking out all competitors. Leading Knight is starting this match off already on fire. Rocky trying to make his feet and get away from Leonidas. Leonidas coming in after him. Springboard! Coke screw elbow. Now Leonidas trying to capitalize.
One, two.
Bobby J made his way back into him to wake up in time. And so goes Rogue, and now Cyclone behind him. Cyclone jumping off the second rope. Where for him? Spot the knees to Bobby J. Cyclone. Springboard but missed. Rogue trying to again capitalize. Remember, he's doing this to prove something to the Fallen. He has yet to have his show actually taken by anyone. He's only given up his name while he's attacking. So we very well could see him kicked out of Blood Ritual. Ooh, big kick. If he does not win right here tonight. Rocky wearing out Cyclone. Now Bobby J trying to wear out Rocky.
Are you good? Do you need
it? Now Cyclone wearing out Bobby J. A trio of headlock. And now Leonidas gets involved. Rocky getting out of it. Cyclone. Now Rocky going for the ankle lock. Jay sizing him up. Kick to the head. Ooh, kick to the back of Rocky Jackson. Might have pulled his leg a little bit. Rogue slithering into the ring. Being taken out by Bobby Jay. Headbutt.
One.
May I remind all of you that these wrestlers are giving it their all in over 90 degrees heat and humidity. Bobby Jay going for Smith's over, but now Rocky has one on him as well.
Do either of you got
Cyclone? Getting involved.
You bastard, just break it up.
Whoa, getting involved as well. Huge drops to get his way out of it. Now fighting with Rogue. Rogue Witcher and Little Rebellion has been having heated feuds for quite a while now. If Rogue can somehow win and pin Lee Nice, he could possibly get another tag team title opportunity for Blood Ritual. But getting a pin, let alone on one specific person, is hard enough. Going for Spartan Knee to Cyclone. Oh, decided that wasn't enough. Fall back elbow.
One, two, two.
We have no idea what's going to be the end of this match. All these wrestlers are going to give it their all. All wrestlers are already so drained. What's Lee Nice going for? Taking out Cyclone. Now Lee Nice might be wasting a lot of his energy. Running around. Oh! You've seen this. Oh! Onto the apron! You've seen it from inside the ring. Now Bobby Jay might have just taken Lee Nice out of this match. And he definitely had a hard landing on that knee. He's wrestling again. What is Cyclone going for? Was gonna go. Huge splash. See that goofiness of jumping to the apron before jumping is gonna cost him. He needs to focus and take this seriously. Whoa, stomping away at the former Intercontinental Champion. Senton!
What?
Rocky out of nowhere breaking up the pin. And he lifted him. Trying to go for a suplex. Rolling over.
What?
This could be it.
Yeah.
Cyclone breaking up that roll up attempt. We still have Lee Nice. And Bobby Jay choking out on the outside, but Bobby Jay trying to make it to his feet. Now Cyclone stomping away at Rogue. Leg drop off the top rope. And we can see from the corner that Bobby Jay did a leg drop to the leg of Rocky Jackson. More submits and my walkie getting involved as well. See, I come. Trying to fight out of it, and I'm Rogue getting the better of it. Huge blows. Remember, Bobby J is still locked in the submission. If Bobby J tapped out what everyone else was dissented, that's still a win. It's not about who is up. Ooh. It's about getting the win, and possibly that could be what ends this match. While everyone is distracted, one wrestler picks up a win from behind. Dissecting the arm of Rogue and breaking up the pin in time. Bobby J on wobbly leg. Managing to continue fighting and kicking. Throwing him into the corner. Now being choked out by Rogue. Remember, there may be no counts, and you can fight it outside the ring all you want. Pinfalls and submission must take place in the ring for this match to end. Clubbing blows. The neck of Rocky. He's getting out of it. Trying to fight back. Throwing him into the corner of that table. Rocky again, the only one standing. Taking out Leonidas and Cyclone. Now trying to size up Bobby J.
Come on, get up.
What is he going for? Ooh! Picture perfect.
One, two.
Oh, we're getting caught into the submission. What is Rogue going for? Oh, trying to go for the finish. I don't think they've realized that Rogue is lying in wait. Double clothesline. Huge frog splash. Oh my, taking out both Rocky and Bobby J. This could be it.
One, two.
Barely kicking out and springboard elbow by Leonidas. And now Cyclone. Will he? Huge splash. Everyone is flying in this matchup. Now Leonidas going to the top again.
One, two.
Everyone is going for a pin.
One, two.
What will it take to get one of these men to be laying down for a count of three?
Let's go!
Chops for everyone. Going out, Rocky. Taking out Cyclone. You got to take out Bobby J. You may just be have enough time to capitalize and keep the Intercontinental title.
One, two.
Cyclone waking up in time. This shows how much the Intercontinental title means to all five of these wrestlers. How long they are going into this match. What they are doing to destroy each other. Rocky Jackson outside picking his spot to get back in. Got out of it. You almost saw what could have been the ending and grabbing up Bobby J's injured leg. Everyone back to their feet. Now Bobby J back to his feet. Trying to pick up Rogue. Rogue not allowing it. Samoan drop. Ooh, Spartan knee.
Hi.
Throwing the dead weight of cycling onto Rogue. Rocky having the pleasure trying to take out Bobby J. Rocky decided to Rogue and Bobby J may have cost him the victory if he does not stay focused on who the man is. And there he goes, making back a twin! Uppercut taking Lean Ice off the top rope. Rocky Jackson could capitalize. Ooh! Spear! Oh, we've seen him do this.
The
likes of Leonidas.
Two.
The Cyclone kicking out. Barely. Everyone is giving it their all right here tonight. Bobby J coming from behind. Ooh.
One, two, three.
Despite
that's
the
it.
Odds.
And
put against
your
him.
Intercontinental champion,
Bobby J
fighter,
walks
Bobby
out.
Jay.
Intercontinental
the
champion.
Past, you know?
Celebrating
day, bro.
You can see the disappointment.
Gotta do it now.
Rocky. Now Rocky's not having any of this. There you go, Rocky. You may not have, oh. What's the Fallen doing out here? Rocky, get out of there. He's not attacking Rocky? Ooh. I thought for a moment he's gonna help Rogue up. But we can say that his invite to being Blood Ritual in the future is not going to happen. But I don't like the way he was looking at Rocky. Well, let's move on from whatever the Fallen has to do with Rocky to Rocky's tag team partner, one half the Young Guns, a member of the Corporate Assassins, Black of Hearts. Now you may question me awarding him a spot in the tournament. His win in the last round with Dark Eagle has an asterisk next to it. But round one, he definitively defended that United States title against Spencer Nightfall and now has an advantage in the finals of this tournament and could be crowned king. Now the reason that man has an advantage because this man in the semifinals had to face a Twisted Jester who he beat via DQ when the Twisted Jester brutalized him with a chair. Now in round one he also cleanly beat Elise and he won his way into the tournament beating Constant and but it doesn't matter what Red H did. It doesn't matter that since losing last year in this tournament, he's been desperately wanting to become king. He will lose. And he may be confident, bringing a spare pair of heel for the finals, just in case he made it, but Confidence will be broken. He will be broken by the COVID assassins. There is no chance Red Ace will win. He is an underdog in this matchup, 100%. But he's representing his heritage strong. But nothing is like representing the Pope assassins.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the final for the King of Wrestling tournament. In this corner, we have Black of Hearts. And in this corner, we have Red Ace. To remind all of you, this is a 10-minute match. Are you ready? Are you ready? Ring the bell.
With 10 minutes on the timer, these two have fought all night to get here, to win this match. It's time to find out who will win. Both these two caught wheel kick. Would love to become king and get that world title match. Because if you win, you don't just become king of wrestling. Ooh, Red Ace dodging a forearm. You get a world title match. And I can't wait to see a Cobra Assassin versus Cobra Assassin main event. Now, speaking of main event, Blue Spade will crown one of these two kings as a way of passing on the crown, being the winner last year. But he also will defend his career next. Right after we find out who becomes king. Red Ace is doing this for heritage. For Black of Hearts, he's doing this for the right reason. Himself.
Because
what is heritage going to do for you? It doesn't help your wrestling ability. No. You know what helps your wrestling ability? Being a culprit. Assassin. Look at that. Smart. Catching the foot. But these two actually have history together. They were both with Rex Silver and Greeny, the first tag team champions in BYWE history about Solitaire. These two are both former and Black Hearts point United States champion. Multi-time tag team champions besides their first reign. These two of though have little similarities when it comes to Red Ace's hardcore title reign. But don't worry, Black of Hearts will make up for that when he adds King to his resume. Now also since leaving Sartre, these two at different times have joined the corporate assassins. But only one man was smart enough to stay in. Now remember a few months ago when I told Red Ace, I warned him to stay out of my path and the path of the corporate assassins. But clearly that hasn't worked. And hopefully he is smart enough to lose this match. He's only won at Mania in the match that beforehand I warned him, but he faced off against some of the corporate assassins, including this man. But this man did tie up those victories this year, winning at Heatwave 2 in the United States Triple Threat, which is possibly more motivation for Red Ace, as these two had a heated feud earlier that month with a cartwheel kick straight to the ribs. Come on, Black Hearts.
Two.
Damn it. So these two have a rich history in this finals. Both exhausted. Black Hearts taking too much time to capitalize. Red Ace using some adrenaline.
He's up.
Lining him up.
He's up.
Ooh, ace in the fox. So. Come on, Black Hearts.
One, two, two.
Black Hearts got out of it. These two need to pick up the pace. They've been through so much tonight. At any moment, they could become king, but they have to remember, pick up the pace. There's a time limit. Buckethot smartly lining him up. Using the body weight. Oh, well, he got caught by Red Ace. I thought he hit the elbow.
Rope break. One, two.
Red Ace trying to capitalize.
Fire first. Do you tap?
No.
Biden, come on, referee. Get this moron.
Do you? No.
Do you think you're gonna
come on? He only got two ropes once. He really should have been made to give him some space. Come on, Blackhawks. You got this, moron beat. Lining him up. Another cartwheel.
5 minutes
kick.
Remain.
And they have reached the halfway point in this match. We really need to pick up the pace if they're going to win this match.
One, two, two.
Red Ace kicking out. I might be mentioned history several times, but history doesn't matter right here, right now. These two who are giving it all night need to focus on right here. Right now. Trying to get some feeling back.
It's just the bloody beginning.
Let's go then. Red Ace now ready to go. A second win for both men. Using the body weight.
Your turn.
Ooh, unique move by Red Ace.
Cero! Vivo divierto!
We've seen him hit this recently. Come on. Come on, Black of Us, come on. Ooh. Come on. No, no, no.
One, two, three!
Red Ace is
completed. The UK will be represented politely. Now, give me what rightfully belongs to me.
Now, King gets
your sword.
Title yeah. Match. Now, getting the crown for the men who eliminated him last year. Former tag team bonus. Red Ace, you are now king of Russia. Congratulations. But not above. There's a few people you're not above. Oh, and there's some of them right there. Cause see, you made the mistake of now being in my crosshairs.
It's enough.
Black of Hearts, listen, you're humble and all, but don't need to stop this fighting. Copa Assassins, stay on him. Don't worry about Cyclone or Blue Spade. Oh, Reddy's getting back into the Cyclone. Getting involved. Saving Red Ace, the former starter brother, now Blue Spade, taking up Black Hearts and now facing off. Oh, Red Silver getting involved. Going at the Black of Hearts. Come on, Hope Assassin. Ooh, Barky got stuck in the middle of a bunch of kicks. Red Ace. Gets
tell
a war title match.
That the king
Barbarian.
Is in charge now.
But you are not in charge. You will not take that war title.
And you can say goodbye to this title when I'm done destroying you.
Did we just see a solitaire reunion for the first time in over a year? Is Red Ace joining back with his solitaire brethren? And it appears that it is true that seeing the friend Red Ace get attacked, that Red Ace is now in the House of Cards once again. But it doesn't matter that he has Solitaire behind him. Because when you have the Corpus Assassin behind him, Corpus Ace will destroy you. The Aero Barbarian will not end.
I want a match for your hardcore title. Empire Rising. What is it gonna take? What do I have to do? Do I have to put my career on the line to get a match with you? Fine. I'm probably rising.
No.
Your hardcore title, my career.
When I was a little girl, my mama said to me, what's your favorite flower, darling? I'll get you the seed. I said, dandelion, dandelion, that one's so pretty. She said, child, that one's not a flower, that one's just a weed. Oh, what a shame. Now it don't look the same. Guess it don't look the same. Oh, what a shame.
I'm picking the stipulation. C-T-3-5. Absolutely everything goes.
Only way to win.
Knock your opponent out.
Oh, what a shame. Now it don't look the same. Guess it don't look the same. Oh, what a shame.
Well, everyone, we have been waiting all night for this match. Bruce Bay walking out to his original theme song and some nice special gear, possibly for the last time. Because not only have we been waiting all night, but we've been waiting for months for this match. Painkiller versus the Fallen. But unfortunately, it's in a way we all would never have expected. Bruce Bates' career is on the line. Eccentric already lost at Mania. At Heatwave 2, the regular Bruce Bates lost. And now it's all up to the Pain Killer to save the career and take the hardcore title in this CT Street Fight. Now, in those months, this man's career has only grown bigger. His stable has only grown bigger and stronger. And this man may just end Blue Spade's career. Bruce Bade has one match. And one opportunity left to prove himself to own his career.
All right, this is a career versus title match, and it is for the hardcore champion. Introducing your challenger and the man risking his career, the Painmaker, Blue Spade, and his opponent, your current hardcore champion, the Fallen. This is a CT street fight, which means the winner is by knockout. Are you ready? Are you ready? Good luck and ring the bell.
So it's an IFO wishing Blue Spade, an ally of his, good luck. This match has only happened once before. Painkiller Blue Spade versus Rex Silver, and Painkiller lost. So this match was his creation. Ooh! Huge smack! And starting off strong!
You want to
good idea, going to the head. Listen, I may hate Blue Spade, but even I do not want to see his career end tonight. Oh! Oh my! Getting caught on the shoulders. Oh! This match can end real quick, but Blue Spade does not appear to be knocked out. Listen, I have a hit to Blue Spade. No one, if you were his friend or enemy, wants to see his career end besides that man, the Fallen. You've seen him play sick and twisted games for months. What is he going? Oh! Gorilla pressing him a little bit over his head. Hanko is now on the defensive. Oh! Huge super kick! Now he's on the offensive. And he's just dead on the offensive. He does not want his career to end here tonight. He's done so much and has so much left to do. Ooh. Been choking down by the Fallen. Now, we all knew this wouldn't be long before these two take it outside of the ring. Ooh. Ooh. Fallen is now in control of this match. Ooh. Oh, we saw this be a big factor in the match between Blue Spade and the Fallen at Heat Wave. But the Fallen won back the hardcore title that he lost a few months ago, wrapping the chain around his fist. This is not gonna be pretty.
Oh!
Ooh. Straight to the ribs. Oh. That could be a quick and easy knockout. Oh, we're now wrapping the chain around his throat.
Blue Spade.
It's Blue Spade. Career is still intact. The Fallen's gonna have to do more. Getting through the feet. Oh! Oh! Chain straight through the face. Now using that broken bamboo stick over the back. Sizing him up. Straight to the ribs. Ooh! DDT on the outside. Sage of his friend Cyclone. Now, what does Blue Spade have in mind? This match can end anywhere. DDT onto the apron.
Chuck him.
That is the hardest punch of the ring.
He's good.
You can see with the exposed under that all the metal is right there. And Fallen just went face forth in the most unprotected part of the apron. Bruce Pretty got a ladder. Possibly a callback to the match where they both competed in the High Risk Ladder match, which was won by Blue Spade. Dance feet and dropping him! Ankle force onto the ladder! Ooh, Blue Spade will care. He don't want just one. Ooh. Blue Spade has something sadistic on his mind. What is he possibly doing? Blue Spade attempting to bridge the ladder over two steel chairs. But what is he gonna do with it? Now grabbing an extra chair for good measure.
Come on, Fallen!
Sizing him up. Ooh! Now what does Blue Spade have in mind? Blue Spade's rolling his way back into the ring. We've known Blue Spade to not really be fond of diving outside the ring. Quick feet by Blue Spade! Ooh! And you got a good view of all Walster, which is watching high up on the hill. We have people up in the shed. Two stories up watching. This matchup, everyone has their eyes on this match. As I say, if you love or hate him, you do not want to see this man's career end. Now Blue Spade's gonna have to do a lot more to beat the Reaper of Souls and save his career. Going on to the apron. What did you have in mind? Oh, now what does the Fallen have in mind? Oh my God! Ooh! Oh my God! Huge side slam! Off the apron, two ladder. Even the ladder couldn't keep the weight of Blue Spade crashing down and collapsed under him. What is the Fallen gonna do to pull up this victory? We've seen this before. Vince is Fallen. Oh. Ooh, going for it again. This match is not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be brutal. It's not about pinfalls, submissions, or technical ability. It's about knocking your opponent out and, oh, possibly reversing the pitcher, and has him in the party favor. A variation of the party favor, locked in onto the Fallen.
Are you good? You need to tap out.
Barely getting out of the finisher. Fallen is going to have to get out of this quick. We've seen him knock out people before. Oh, now choking him. As I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be vicious and it's gonna be brutal. Clubbing blow to the back of Blue Spade and now picking him up. What does the Fallen have in mind? Blue Spade trying to save himself. Where's he going? Cole? Oh, twisting the arm. No way you're gonna be able to hit this. On the second rope! Blue in the face! A callback to one of the big moments from Mania. But then knock him out when Fallen hit the his finisher onto Blue Spade at Mania. It was something to watch, and now Blue Spade getting redemption months later. Now making a pile of chairs onto the Fallen. How many chairs does Blue Spade need? The Fallen is buried under this pile of chairs. Ooh, crushing him. What does Blue Spade have in mind? It's something. Is mine lining him up? Ooh! Ooh! Punt kick!
Still good.
Blue Spade. He's gonna have to do more. He's gonna have to do what he's done, but as a painter, and kill the phone pain. Now he has something sadistic in mind. What is he going? Oh, the pile driver is banned, but anything goes into the smash. Ooh! Ooh! Onto this pile of chairs! Pile driver is banned, but anything goes in the CT street fight. And somehow, the Fallen is perfectly okay. Well, not perfectly okay, but he's not knocked out. What is it gonna take? A punt kick? A pile driver? Nothing has put away the Fallen. Fallen trying to get back into it. Now the Fallen has something sadistic in mind. No. No, no, no. No, come on. Blue Spade, get out of this. Get out of this. Ooh! Ooh! Onto the pile of chairs, a super flex. Spencer Nightfall was scared to go and check up on him. Oh my god. Oh my god, how is Blue Spade not knocked out? Blue Spade though. Half of these moves, not just that move. If that was a regular match, you could have pinned someone off of it. Locking his horn as he beats him down. This was any regular match, this would have been over these things that these two are doing to each other. They do not care about each other's well-being. The Fallen just wants to end Blue Spade's career, and Blue Spade just wants to desperately take out the Fallen and do anything in his power to save his career. But right now, his career looks very much in jeopardy. Face force into those chairs. Not letting Spencer Nightfall check on him. Staring into the soul of Blue Spade. Going to the top rope again. Oh, Potsy going for a side slam. Off the second rope. Oh! Blue Speed! Body Fable! On the top rope! Guys, I'm in the head scissors are falling. Thank God of it. Head scissors are locked back in! Ooh! Face force from the top rope! They're falling! He could be knocked out! Fallen is still in this match. What is it gonna take for one of these two men to win here tonight? These two are giving it all in the heat. Choking out the Fallen. Trying to viciously knock him out in the most painful way imaginable. Blue Spade again piling up the chairs. What does Blue Spade have to do? Going for a DDT? Oh, no, 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 no! Oh! Oh, no! That's it! Barely saving his career! Now, hand falls drapely to the ground, but he is still in this match! Blue Spade's career is still intact! But at what cost to his well-being is Blue Spade going through right now? Like, at this point, if he loses this match, at the amount of pain he's going through, it doesn't even matter. He could be ruining his entire life with the pain he's going through. And, oh, Fallen, no. No, no, no. Kids, of everything you've seen in this match, do not try this at home. Choking him. Blue Spade needs to get out of this. Taking him up higher. No, no, no. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Someone go check on him. Sponge knife up. Someone. Oh my God. Oh my God. This is it. How? How is Blue Spade in this match, let alone not going to the hospital? Ooh. Desperately fighting out of it. Blue Spade getting some space. What is he going for? Ooh. Charging at the Fallen. With the last bit of adrenaline possibly he has. Is this it? No. What is Blue Spade gonna have to do here tonight? These two have given it their all. Ooh. Threw him into the barricade. Now over the barricade. What does Blue Spade have in mind? Jumping off the... Ooh! Could have broken his forearms or limbs right there. We don't know what Blue Spade has left. Ooh! He may be running purely on desperation. And now another ladder is coming into his match. Listen, Blue Spade has put up a fight. If he loses here tonight, he can call this a match worth fighting for. But I think at this point, one of these men should just give up for the betterment of their full livelihood, not just a career. Listen, there's more to life than wrestling. Bruce Bray does not need to be doing this. He does not need to be risking his safety the way he is tonight. He's facing a literal reaper, a person who has stolen souls. We have seen him. He has stolen my soul. He has stolen Constantial. He's been given souls by people like the Dark Eagle and Elise. What does Bruce Bray even have on his mind? And will it even be enough? I've been asking those two questions, but we have not found the answer of what will be enough to end this match. What will it take to save Bruce Bray's career or end it? This match is not just about giving in. It's about physically not going anymore. Oh. Blue in the face. And Bruce Bray is leaving? What is Bruce Bray going for now? What? Bruce Bray is now going to the shed. We have no idea what he's going for, but Fallen could be out. Oh, wait. No, Bruce Bray, no. That's a second story window. That's not meant for jumping out of. Blue Spade. Come on, someone go talk to him. Looking into the sky. Come on. Red Ace, Black of Arts, Rex Silver, one of you go talk to him. Blue Spade, don't have to do this. Blue Spade, come on, you don't have to do this. Oh. Oh. Oh my. This is it. Fallen World out of the way. Bruce Bray's career over. No? No! Bruce Bray is somehow still in this. Fallen World out of the way in the last second. But Bruce Bray is somehow still in this match. He's just fell from a second story window. Not this fell, he jumped on two ladders. He can pile drive it. Ooh. And now, that finisher straight to the ladder. Now rolling in, Bruce Bray's possibly unconscious body. It could be just a matter of moments. Bruce Bray, career could be over. We could just have witnessed his final match. Finisher multiple times, and Fallen's going for again. And listen, Bruce Bray, what you've gone through tonight, it's all worth it. You have made your career in BYWE and backyard wrestling. You can call it a day. So you have something to be proud of. Now going for the finisher of the second rope. He starts to be ready. Bruce Bray, not fully out. DDT off the second rope. Blue Spade is not knocked out. He's somehow still just running that skull into his face. The skull that's keeping souls stuck in it. What is Blue Spade going for? Oh, another steel chair. Oh, but. Wait, he's not going for the Fallen. Ooh. The skull is crushed under a steel chair. Ah! Heart kick.
That's it.
Blue Spade has saved his career.
Blue Spade champion is
the Painmaker. enough fight. There's enough will be duplicated. You will stay a save his career. You know tonight. You need to find a way to get you through another day. Fallen let me be the one to luckily. Numb you out. Admiring his handiwork.
Let me be the one to hold you. Never gonna let you get away.
The shoulder you cry on. The toast that you throw
like you on. I'm not that no one will ever forget.
I walked so long, so hard to get to where I am. And if you guys think that I am leaving just yet, you have another thing coming. Expect a lot more of Blue Spade.
I know what you want so desperately. You know I'll give you one for free. Forever you're coming back to me.
Now I'm gonna give you what you need.
Cause I know what you feed on and what you lean on and what you lean on. The shoulder you cry on. The toes that you throw you on.
I'm not a person like this. I'm happy to see you stay, stay in BY. Definitely. I think all of them are
happy.
But in this era, the era of blood is left. Now his brother, Rex Silver, handing him the match. And now it's not even about hating each other or not. It's about friends celebrating together that their friend's career is not over.